There's a lot of studies out there that show that improved health literacy results in improved health outcomes. I think if we can improve health literacy of the population, everybody wins.
This tool that we're developing is not for somebody who's an expert. We want to develop tools that help everybody, people who provide information and also people who read information, so that you can make good or better decisions about your healthcare.
Communication is really important. What this does has the potential to overcome some communication deficits of healthcare providers who may be too complex or not targeted appropriately.
We wanted to move away from rules of thumb that aren't really based on science. And so we started from the foundation of trying to look at text and text characteristics and understand what makes text difficult, what makes it simple.
Over time, people usually associate it simpler with shorter, which is not the case. Now we have better tools that we can say a simpler word is a word that is more commonly used on the entire internet. We can look at how topics are distributed in text and how many times a text switches from one topic to the other and then back to the first one. So we discover principles that can increase health literacy.
Celiac disease is a long-term autoimmune disorder, primarily affecting the
with the creation of a lot of these virtual assistants, audio becomes more important. And there is nothing out there, there are no guidelines out there that tell you how to create understandable information using audio.
The main advantage of audio is really accessibility. And so this is really one of the motivators for this project. How do you move to having concrete rules that people can use to help guide the use of audio for health literacy?
The use of audio is certainly nothing new when I see patients and we communicate with audio. But what this does is make it possible to meet the person where they are. It can take existing information and make it into precision communication.
This is funded by the National Library of Medicine. I think it was a really good fit from the beginning because all the important characteristics for us are also important for them. They care about data sets, computational tools, but also about impact on the population and the patients. Extramural research, I think, is important because you tap into intellectual potential across the country, maybe across the world. So you broaden the input, the ideas, the synergy for projects that are important.